Okay, hello people. It's been a while now. Day 93 or night 93. It's going down to minus 19 tonight, so yeah, I'm gonna really freeze my rear end out. Definitely. So, it's gonna be interesting. So, yeah, even though my feet, I had those little slipper things for my feet. They still get quite cold when it gets really cold at night. So what I did was I reversed the electric blanket and put there's a big plastic thing right in the middle of it. It used to be behind my neck. So I ended up putting it at the other end of the place where I sleep. And the wires are just long enough. Like, it's just crazy that they make the wires so short. But so I put it down at the bottom where my feet are. So my feet are, you know, dealing with the lump of plastic. And what it's doing is it's keeping my feet warm at night. So it's not actually an electric blanket, it's called an electric throw, and I got it for like $29 at, I think it was Costco that I got it at quite a few years ago. And now the same thing costs about $100, so I don't understand that, like, but anyways, and they don't sell them, I can't find them at Costco anymore. I can find them on Amazon, but they're like $90, so it's not worth buying a $90 short little electric. Not that I would buy, I need another one or anything like that. It's just, if this one fails on me, I'm kind of, you know, I'm kind of stuck. Like, that's what keeps me warm at night. So, I kind of wanted to have an extra one kicking around if they were still $30, but no, not paying $90 for one. And I did try putting my new electric blanket in there, which is bigger, it's a twin size, but it killed the battery, so it draws way more power, and I didn't even have it turned up. I had it on number 3 out of 10, so I don't know if that was just something weird or what, but when it's not going to be so cold, I will try it again. But anyway, so because it's not very long, it only comes up to right where my pillow is, so that's fine. I don't need it to heat my head. So yeah, I put it from the bottom upward, so now my feet sort of, you know, I've had it that way for the last 4 or 5 days, and it has worked out just fine. So, and if I had the money, I'd go and buy another one of these batteries, another AGM battery to put in here with this one. But I don't have the money, so can't do that. But yeah, they're like $250 plus tax. You're looking at like $300. So yeah, I don't have the money. If I could though, if I could get one, it would be great to put in beside the other battery here, and that way I could use the bigger electric blanket, and it would last me all night. But as it stands right now, that 80 amp hours, somehow I end up using that up. So I only tried it one night because I didn't want to freeze two nights in a row, but I woke up, I don't know, around 5 o'clock in the morning, and the inverter was beeping saying it was low voltage, and the solar charger had already switched the output off. So it definitely went down low. So, but yeah, tonight's going to be fun. Minus 19. I am going to freeze the old proverbial brass, you know what's, from the monkey. So, I'm just here at McDonald's having a coffee and getting ready to go. It's early, it's only 8:30. I'm getting ready to go and crawl in. Not looking forward to it. It's going to be minus 10 with a minus 19 wind chill. And it snowed a little while ago. We got about 3 inches of snow, or at least that's what I got on the car. And a lot of that probably blew off the roof at the locker. I cooked up pizza pockets, you know, those little thingies. I just put them in the lunch pail, like, warming thing. Took about an hour or so to warm them up. They were frozen, so took about an hour to warm them up, good and warm, and that's what I had for dinner. So yeah, I don't have much food at this particular moment in time, and I got like $20 left in my wallet, so I don't know what to do. I'm gonna have to, like, can of beans is what I had last night. They're only a dollar for a can of beans, and that's all I need to eat in one night. That's fine. I need to go and get some more, at least spend $10 on food. Speaking of spending money, I need to cut back on the gas. I don't need the car running. I just had it running to get me warm in here, because it's quite cold outside. So yeah, things are getting pretty tight. I'm not going to be able to do this much longer, but I got no other choice. I got no place to go. So that, you know, if I lose the locker, which it costs me a lot of money every month for that, which I gotta pay tomorrow. I probably got another month or so. But yeah, I've been looking every day for a job, and it's just crazy. But anyways, they ended up finding me frozen in the back of here or something. Because once the if I don't have the locker, first of all, I'm going to lose all my stuff. There's thousands of dollars worth of stuff in there. I tried selling a lot of it. I do have somebody coming on Thursday to look at the CNC machine, so hopefully it's not a waste of my time or gas to drive over there and show it to the guy. But if I sell that, I'll have a little bit of extra cash, but even that's not going to last very long. So I've been going through stuff today, throwing this and that out, and you know, just going through everything. I got lots of stuff to sell, but it's really difficult to sell, even though, you know, I got marketplace and everything. And anyways, and the cell phone, you know, so the bill for the cell phone is $197 this month. Normally it was $100. So somehow I ended up with a $200 bill from trying to upgrade my phone and then sending it back. And then, you know, they were supposed to give me a 20 gig package. Now it's saying it's only 12 gig. I don't know. So I gotta phone them tomorrow, I guess, and haggle it out with them. And, you know, I was gonna do it all on my phone and everything, and I just called the guy to ask him, you know, because it kept coming up and saying to me that plan that I'm on is not compatible. So I phoned, and the guy said, oh no, don't worry about that. You know, I said, well, will it turn my data off until my new phone comes? And they go, no, no, he said, here, I'll fix it up for you. Just tell me what you want to do. And so I told him, blah, 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 blah. Anyways, they charged me $45 for that. Meanwhile, it's free if you do it on your phone. So, you know, I didn't call the guy to get him to switch it all over. I called the guy just to ask a couple questions. And anyways, so I gotta phone them and try and figure out why they're charging me $45 when I'm a repeat customer and nothing's changed. My phone number hasn't changed or nothing. So if it costs $45 just to change your plan, that's ridiculous. That's a ripoff. Anyways, things aren't going very good. I'm not going to bore you all with this, but yeah, give me a thumbs up. Yeah, hopefully I make it through the night at minus 19. And, yeah, please hit the subscribe button if you're not a subscriber, and you know all the rest of it. Thanks for watching, guys.